you make some ethical food choices. What can you tell me?
Well, I went to a farm animal rescue at Daybra some years back,
Thank you. Flight delays and cancellations are continuing across the country this afternoon after an incident at the Sydney airport. The control tower was evacuated late this morning after smoke was detected. All planes were prevented from taking off or landing for about an hour. It's believed the smoke came from an overheating computer backup battery system that spread through the control tower's air conditioning. The federal opposition has set the stage for another political fight over the Murray-Darling Basin, pledging to make major changes to the management plan and scrap a deal struck last year. Cassie Briggs reports.
Basin states last year agreed no socio-economic damage should be done attempts to recover the final 450 gigalitres of water in the Murray-Darling Basin plan. That deal was slammed by a South Australian Royal Commission. Now Labor frontbencher Tony Burke I don't see how you will ever get 450 gigalitres of water that way. Federal Water Minister David Littleproud says Labor's position is a hoax.
But you can't deliver the basin plan unless you have all the basin states to agree.
The South Australian government says Labor's plan risks blowing up the entire basin plan.
A senior US diplomat concedes America may have taken Australia for granted on issues of trade. Arthur Culverhouse recently took up an ambassadorial post in Canberra. He says while China is Australia's largest export market, the US is the biggest investor in Australia.
In fact,
inside the 24-storey building, about 70 were injured. Germany has extended its ban on arms sales to Saudi Arabia for a further 6 months. A halt was ordered last October after the killing of Saudi dissident journalist Jamal Khashoggi in Turkey. Germany's weapons freeze has drawn criticism from other EU countries because of its impact on joint defence projects. And briefly in tennis, Ash Barty is through to the final of the Miami Open. The Australian beat Estonian player Annette Kontaveit in straight sets this morning. Queensland's weather: showers and storms continuing tomorrow for the north and east. Showers and possible severe storms in the southeast. Brisbane and the Sunshine Coast 22 to 30. The Gold Coast 21 to 28. And at Ipswich 21 to 29. Mostly fine for the southeast on Sunday and Monday. A shower or two on Tuesday. Auckland Bay south to southeasterlies reaching 20 knots. This is ABC News.
ABC Radio Traffic.
Bypass outbound right lane for the RA tunnel at Bowen Hills. So traffic is getting back towards Hale Street at the moment, but it looks like towing's on site and hopefully that crash should be cleared fairly shortly. At Castlezone, I'm going to break down, keep you running about right turn lane at Beams Road and Hamilton. Got a crash report at King Smith Drive inbound lanes, just near Quarry Street, inbound lanes back to London at this stage, and also the Farm Lane travel site.
Rocking the Canadian tuxedo today. We did country last week.
I know I should.
Last week, what was I thinking?
Last week. And
to see you as always. And we've got David Brady here today. Hello, David.
David, so
we'd know David from my friend the Chocolate Cake, from Wandering Waving, from his solo records. You've had a big connection with Queensland, David, with the work you've done with the Papua New Guinea community here and so forth.
Yeah, in the South of the Island community.
Yeah.
At the Queensland Music Festival, and Emily Boromara, who's a local Brisbane girl by Grecian Island. She's on One Talk Label, so yeah.
Yeah, and you've got a new album called The Wisdom Line, which is out this week.
I do, yes. Yeah, it's come out recently. I've got a couple of songs off that. Pretty happy with it.
No, I'm so pleased to have you here. Thank you.
The Wisdom Line.
Yes.
Explain.
I was looking for a title for my record, and I was having a retreat down at Phillip Island, and this big frigate was sailing out towards their heads. The head outside, past their heads, was rough seas, was blue sky over the bay, and on the side of the frigate was the Wisdom Line. And I thought, you know, it's like the coconut hitting you on the head. It was
divine
a sign, but it's also, you know, this aspirational thing. We try to do things better than we actually do, so we aspire to that Wisdom Line, perhaps never getting.
I just love the idea of wisdom. I think it's something that's, well, it needs a bit more airtime, doesn't it?
It
wisdom.
Certainly does, yes.
And indeed, stay listening, because at the very end of this hour, we'll bring you Astrid Jorgensen's weekly musical, a satirical take of the new set to music. You do not want to miss it. It's fantastic. And, yeah, what a week to recap satirically. You are on ABC Radio, but you'll be hearing from David Brady live this month, a couple of wonderful tracks from the album, as well as some songs that you've selected and mean something to you, and I think we're going to give Emily a little bit of a spin. Sean Sennett, you've brought a stack of hot tracks.
I know, a lot of music to get through.
As ever, your gig guide's locked and almost loaded. You wanted to kick off with a little bit of Sahara Beck this afternoon.
Yeah, I did. Sahara Beck is a great local artist. This is the second single, I guess a fourth coming out, which might come out later this year or next year. The song's called I Haven't Done a Thing Today. It came out yesterday.
I don't like to drink caffeine, but I am still a party queen. All my friends. Thank you.